Hi everybody, today we will be playing with heatmaps, which will allow you to easily explore huge OMICs datasets. This will be transformed into this. Our playground will be the XLSTAT software. Suppose you have a data table with thousands of proteins in rows, quantified over a bunch of maize leaf samples stored in columns. Samples are extracted according to four different methods. And here we go! Go to the XLSTAT OMICs menu and select the heatmap feature. Select the data in the Features Individuals field. To select the whole dataset, you just need to click on a random cell and press CTRL plus A. In the Options tab, we will ask XLSTAT to remove a couple of proteins with low variability across samples. This will improve heatmap clarity. Let's remove all proteins with an interquartile range lower than 0.25. In the Charts tab, you'll be able to choose among three different color palettes of maps. I will choose red to green. Now we're done. And here's the heat map. This is how it works. First, samples and proteins are clustered independently. Then rows and columns are permuted accordingly. This brings similar samples close to each other in columns and similar proteins close to each other in rows. The heat map is a colored representation of the data. Here, red stands for low values, green for high values, and black for intermediate values. Let us first focus on how samples are clustered with each other. The dendrogram clearly shows three distinct groups. The rightmost cluster involves samples extracted using the TEAL method. The middle cluster includes TCA1 samples. Samples quantified using the URNB and URZB methods are clustered together here. Now let's switch to proteins. The vertical dendrogram separates two groups, which may represent two different protein families, for instance. Now we reach the most exciting part. We will see if protein clusters are associated to sample clusters. Take a closer look at the TEAL samples. They exhibit low quantities of proteins belonging to group 2, and high quantities of proteins belonging to group 1. The URNB and URZB cluster shows an opposite pattern. Finally, the TCA1 samples produce intermediate quantities of proteins. Nevertheless, there is some kind of an increasing gradient from the bottom to the top of the map. The heatmap tool allowed us to easily investigate three important questions on a big dataset. How samples cluster with each other, how features cluster with each other, and if clusters of similar samples correspond to clusters of similar features. Why don't you give it a try?